Hey everybody, and welcome to another Jamovi tutorial. In this tutorial, we are going to explore an additional module that you can add to your Jamovi suite of functions. This is great. So this is beyond just normal statistics tutorial. This is using a new kind of module to expand your use of Jamovi, right? If you're still reticent about using R. So how we add this is by going up to module. So that's where we're going to add it. So I'm going to click on that, and I'm going to go to Jamovi, adding the available modules that you can. So I'm going to go to install because I already have it installed. And I'm going to show you exactly what we're going to be working with. We're going to be talking about Statkat method selection tool. This tool will help you find an appropriate statistical method given your research question and the measurement level of your data. And what they mean by measurement level is what kind of scale is it? Is it continuous? Is it discrete? Is it nominal, ordinal, etc.? So we are going to jump in there. And it's got a great little icon here. It's an S. That looks like a cat. So it's Statkat. So Statkat is going to help us with some stuff. So you can see here that there are three different submodules to help you figure out what you're going to do. And I am using the Chico 2 dataset from the library. Now, this is students with different grades and different times. So time is a nominal variable, and grade test is a continuous slash scale variable. So let's talk about single variable. Let's jump into here. And the great thing about Statkat is it gives you this set of information. So you can pause and read that, or you can jump into it on your own Jamovi. So what it wants to do for a single variable is to do a scatter plot. And so I'm going to throw in grade test here, and it's going to show me a scatter plot of grade test. Now, it says you have entered a numeric variable, hence the one sample t-test or the population mean may be a good option for you. Here's how to do it. T-test, one sample t-test. Boom, right there. Great. Drop your variable in the box below the dependent variable. Under hypothesis, fill in the value for mu naught in the box next to the test value and select your alternative hypothesis. If the normality assumption is violated, this is great stuff. You can use a nonparametric Wilcoxon signed rank test for the population median instead. And so here's what the data looks like. You have got your grade test. The scale isn't that great, but we'll do that. So I'm going to leave that up because I want to do that one more time. And this time I want to use time. So we bring the other one up here and we have something that's not applicable. That's interesting. So we have ones and twos. And so you have entered a dichotomous variable. Well, we know that this is not actually a dichotomous variable. Hence the binomial test for the population proportions of successes may be a good option for you. So just be aware that if you put a categorical variable that has two options, it's probably going to indicate a binomial test each time. Drop your dichotomy. So two outcomes, binomial test. So we go frequencies and we click on here, two outcomes, binomial test. Drop your dichotomous variable in the white box, fill in the value for pi naught in the box next to the test value. Under hypothesis, select your alternative. Click on the link to learn more about this test. So if you were to click on this link. But, you know, that kind of doesn't, I wanted to point this out because that doesn't really fit with our actual data set. So let's go back into Statkat and let's do relationships, prediction, and group comparisons. And let's see what it says here. So we want to go ahead and put grade test in the dependent variable since it's a dependent variable and it's continuous. And most of the stuff we do in the general linear model has a continuous dependent variable. It's measured in some way. Okay. And so this, again, you can pause it and look at what this whole thing is saying. I am not going to read it out loud because it's a lot. But imagine this is what we're going to be doing to determine if we need to use a t-test, an independent samples t-test, or a dependent samples t-test, although repeated measures is a separate thing. So we'll just have to see. And we'll go ahead and put time as the independent variable. And so it's got this NA, and I'm not entirely sure why it's putting that in there. But in any case, what it's going to do with this one now is it thinks that there is two times. There are two times, and that's how this data set is actually set up. It's set up like an independent samples t-test, but we know that it's not supposed to be set up this way. We know that it shouldn't be set up this way for a paired samples t-test because you need to have two columns for measurements for a paired samples t-test to create your pairs. So you've entered a numeric variable for variable one, dependent variable, and dichotomous variable for variable two. So because it's reading that, it suggests that it's assuming that these are independent sample groups. You have one column for independent variable one and two, right here. And then you have your dependent variable on the y-axis as one column. And so that's what it's suggesting. Go to t-test, independent samples t-test, and there you go. And you put all of your stuff in. And if you violate normality, you can go to Mann-Whitney. You can use the Mann-Whitney u-test. You can click on that to learn more about it. Now, so that's very interesting, right? Because we have an interesting bivariate correlation here in this data set. But we know that it's not set up properly. So let's see what Statkat, and I chose this data set on purpose. So let's see what Statkat says about repeated measurements and what it needs us to do for repeated measurements. Okay. So it looks here that we're probably not going to be able to do this because we don't have two related variables. We have one variable that's continuous and one variable that is dichotomous, one and two. So here, and again, pause if you want to read what this says. Here again, so if I put these two in here, watch what happens. It can't it can't figure this out, right? Because we have scores up here and then we have time down here and it's reading ones and twos. So it's reading all numeric data on one single measurement, and that just doesn't make sense. So we can't do this. So we have to modify this data. And again, one of the strengths of Jamovi is being able to modify the data. So what we're going to do is we are going to create a new variable, and we are going to make this a continuous variable, and we're going to call this grade grade test 2. And so it's going to be a decimal. And that's how we are going to do it. Now, what we're going to do is we are going to grab these data and we are going to, we're just going to copy them, I think. And we're going to put them there. Okay. Now, you can do one of two things. You can, now that I've set that up, so that is just the repeat of this data over here in this column. Now, we can do one of two things. We can filter by time and say we only want the one. So if we go to filter, We only want ones. And so when we put grade test and grade test two in this repeated measure Statcat, it will only take these variables here. It will only take those. Or we can create a new variable on here. And I think for the sake of ease, I'm just going to create a new variable. So we're going to create a new variable and we're going to call this grade test. Got to get that underscore in there. Grade test one. And we're going to call that continuous, and we're going to give it a decimal. And we are just going to highlight over here, copy and control V, control C, or command C, command V. Those are the two ways that you can do this. And there we go. We have two new variables that have new data in them, or the same data. But when we go back to StatCat here, so we can't do this. So we're going to go to StatCat one more time, and we're going to do repeated measurements. And we're going to put grade test one and two into the related variable box. And you can see here that you have entered two related numeric variables. Hence, the paired sample t-test seems to be the good option for you. So you go to t-test, paired sample. I love it. Paired samples t-test. Drop the two pair variables, and there you go. If you violate normality, then you can use the Wilcoxon signed rank test, similar to the one that we had up here. So I can scroll up. This one, Wilcoxon signed rank test, it's the same rank test, just used in a slightly different way than the one sample t-test. But here you go. That's how to do this. And I think this is a wonderful teaching tool to have the StatCat module added to Jamovi and then using it to explore how the data is read and then what is being suggested for you. I think that's a wonderful, wonderful module. Play around with it with your data sets. Let me know how it goes. Leave your comments, suggestions, and feedback down below. If you like this content, please consider leaving a like. If you want to see more, consider subscribing for more Jamovi tutorials. Thanks for watching.